Bugiardo. Bugiardo. Con questa faccia da bugiardo. Era tutto uno scherzo, sono un bugiardo. La tua ragazza ha capito, sono un bugiardo.
What's up guys, P-Monty89 here. Doing a brand new review on one of the older guns that I have. My very first handgun, being the Charter Arms Pathfinder. I got this on my 21st birthday, and I'm doing a new review on it because I felt that it needed a new review. I'll keep the old one up though. But anyway, let's get right down to it. This is a Charter Arms Pathfinder snub-nose revolver, chambered in the 22 Magnum. It has a 2-inch barrel. It is a double single action, as you can see. It's a 6-shot revolver, and don't worry, these are spent shells in here. I'm going to use these to simulate the trigger pull in just a moment. This gun I got for $355. After everything was said and done, you can get them cheaper now, probably about $320, give or take, depending on where you are. I really do like this revolver a lot for what it is. Charter Arms does give you a lifetime membership, or not a lifetime, sorry, a 1-year membership free to the NRA when you get the gun. It'll come right in the box, a free membership for a year. I added wood grips to mine because I wanted something that would slip in and out of the pocket real easy and shorten the height of the gun a little bit, which this does, over the standard rubber grips that they give you. I do like the gun a lot. It's 19 ounces, so it's really not that heavy. You can find airweight revolvers and Smith & Wessons for lighter, but, you know, 19 ounces would not faze me at all to carry around. And I carry the CCI Maxi Mag Plus V rounds, or I'll just carry the Maxi Mag Full Metal Jackets for this gun. Spear and Hornaday are both making defensive loads for this now, but they have not been tested out in the field yet. Until that happens, I'm not switching from CCI, because as far as I'm concerned for right now, they're still the most reliable rimfire ammunition. So I highly recommend CCI for the gun. Like I said, this is all American, and people were asking me, you know, how reliable is the Charter Arms, are they any good? Well, I'll say this, they are pretty good for the money, okay? They're not a Smith & Wesson, but they will get the job done, and they are pretty reliable, as are most revolvers out there. So, you know, you really can't beat that if you don't have a lot of money. A revolver's the best bet. Let me just zoom in here on the sights. Show you the sight picture. I can zoom in a little bit. Okay. There's your sight picture. Basic for a snub-nose revolver. The trigger pull on this gun, on the 22 Magnum version, is 11 pounds, and I'll simulate it real quick. That's the trigger pull in double action, which isn't too bad as far as I'm concerned. And in single action, they advertise 4 pounds, so let's do single action. So you can see it's pretty effortless. So, I mean, it's a really good revolver for people that are new to concealed carry. 22 Magnum does pack quite a punch. It is pretty affordable to shoot, despite what others might say, because they're comparing it to 22 long rifle, which is the cheapest to shoot, and nothing really comes close to that. 22 Magnum ammunition costs between what the 22 long rifle higher quality and the lower quality 9mm cost, so right in between the two. You're looking at about $11 a box for the good CCIs, the higher quality CCIs, which doesn't bother me at all. You know, you only need 6 rounds in the gun to carry. If you want to carry speed loaders, I'd say like maybe 2 would be all you need. And I will be showing you after and a demonstration how effective it is to use a speed loader in these little charter arms. If you're going to use speed loaders, I highly recommend that you convert your handle to the wood grips. This is made right out of Connecticut. It's really, you know, a nice gun. So with that said, let's take a look at some footage here on my demonstration on how to carry the gun proper, how to draw it out of the holster, and putting in speed loaders. Remember, when you put in speed loaders, you want to take advantage of gravity. The first thing you want to do is put your fingers here on the cylinder. Then you want to eject, just like so. Okay? And, that one didn't come all the way out, but that's okay. Yeah, I think it hit the wood grip a little bit. But, I'd say you want to eject them, so you're not putting any stress on the cylinder. If you're just pushing down like this, you're putting all that stress on the between the ejector rod and the cylinder. What you want to do is wrap your fingers around it and push out like so. Hold it directly down and push out like that. Now, some of you guys might be saying, well, won't I burn my fingers doing that? No, the cylinder doesn't get hot right away. Maybe after about 50, 60 rounds, it'll start getting kind of hot. Then you got to start worrying. I mean, some of those revolvers, they're not made to be shooting a million rounds at one time out of them, but they will hold up. So don't worry about that. And with that said, I'm going to get out of here and show you the simulation I put up. There's a lot of myths that have not been proven that say that you cannot use a speed loader in this gun, and that it's not reliably able to eject the rounds and all that kind of stuff. And today we have the Charter Arms Pathfinder, and I'm going to dispel those myths real quick. Also, if you have a single double action revolver with the hammer like this on a snubby, the best way to go about drawing it out would be to, while you're drawing it out, keep your thumb right over the hammer to avoid snagging. Okay. And mainly I made this video to show that you can, in fact, use speed loaders. And we're going to do this pretty safe. When you draw out your gun, by the way, you want to draw it out with, you know, your thumb here, like I said, but you want to make sure your finger's off the trigger when you're pulling it out to avoid accidental discharges and what have you. We're going to simulate today with six spent. All right, these are spent cartridges. As you can see, the primer has been hit several times. This is just I'm using expanded shells that have already been shot for realistic purposes with the way the gun ejects and all that. So without further ado, we're going to try this out. I have just a little bit of practice with this now, so we'll see how quick I can do it. Give you an idea if you're considering a snub-nosed revolver for concealed carry. So I'm going to put it right in the waistband here. Bring it in there. Okay. And, all right, so, 3, 2, 1. Okay, and you would just eject the shells, go into the pocket, and when you're loading them out, you want to make sure that the gun is down like so, put the speed loader right in like this. That way, gravity helps, and you can see the bullets go right in. And you're ready to go again. When you're done, boom, boom, you're ready to go again. Okay, now there are guys out there that can do that way faster than me, and either with a little bit of practice, I can get way faster, but I'm just demonstrating. Maybe I'll cut the video real quick, and we'll do this again without me talking at all. That way, it'll concentrate on the reloads faster, but there you are. The Charter Arms, and you're able to use a speed loader for this gun. And I do highly recommend Charter Arms for those that are on a budget. I'll be doing a new review on this gun shortly, so let me cut the video, and then we're going to try this again real quick, see how fast I can go.
Ogni gioia, ogni sbaglio, ogni test, ogni cosa che odio i police, eppure Sting, perché stava nei police. Odio i figli di chi c'ha i soldi, le nostre cicatrici contro i vostri lifting. Una guida spinta, uno street imprinting, collo a V e Gucci jeans.